For more than 70 years, antibiotics and other drugs known collectively as antimicrobial agents have helped reduce illness and death from infectious diseases. However, these drugs have been used for so long that certain microbes, such as E. coli, have evolved to become resistant to their effects. As a result, drug-resistant infections are on the rise, leading to longer, more expensive hospital stays and increasing the risk of death.
Drug resistance, if you take it to its extreme, could actually mean taking us back many, many years prior to the time when we had effective antibiotics.
Dr. Anthony Fauci is the director of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, or NIAID.
For patients, it may be that the options that they have for treatment might be less.
Drug resistance can happen in several ways, depending on the microbe involved. For example, cephalosporins are a class of antibiotics commonly prescribed for bacterial infections. These drugs work in different ways, one of which is by inhibiting cell wall synthesis, a bacterial process important for survival. Some germs, such as MRSA, have evolved the ability to recognize these drugs and block their function. Antibiotic-resistant bacteria can inhibit cephalosporins by producing specialized enzymes, called beta-lactamases, that break a drug's molecular bonds and change its structure. The emergence and spread of drug resistance has cast new light on how people use antimicrobials. Overprescribing or misusing these drugs can accelerate the development of resistant pathogens. To slow it down, researchers and public health officials support using antimicrobials only when necessary.
One of the things that we need to educate physicians as well as the general public, physicians, to make sure that they don't inappropriately use antibiotics, and the general public to make sure that they don't put pressure subtly or directly on physicians to prescribe antibiotics under circumstances when maybe antibiotics are not indicated, such as in an obvious viral infection. That's one of the most important misuses of antibiotics today.
To combat drug resistance, scientists, funded by NIAID and other agencies, are studying the biology of microbes and developing faster diagnostic tests that will make it easier for doctors to determine the appropriate treatment for an infection. Researchers are also determining the optimal use of existing antimicrobials and advancing new drugs and vaccines to target drug-resistant microbes.
In the areas of understanding the pathogenesis of the development of resistance, including genomic sequencing of the microbes, in the development of point-of-care diagnostics, in the development of therapeutics, the pipeline of new drugs, and finally in the development of vaccine. All of those things are part of the purview of what NIAID does.